2010 Chinese movie The Piano in a Factory depicts just how much a piano was an aspirational goal of Chinese households in the early 90s, as a laid-off steel worker builds one by hand to try and keep custody of his daughter through a bitter divorce. Today, piano stores across China look like this, devoid of customers. Once a status symbol to own, domestic piano production last year plunged to half what it was just 4 years ago. The central government desperately wants households to spend more to fight entrenched deflation, but it too is tightening its fiscal belt.
We will practice frugality and economy and reject extravagance.
Without question, the average Chinese middle-class consumer can be a big spender. But we also know that households are feeling the pinch from a slowing economy, exacerbated by falling home prices and a stock market rout. Now, after the Mao Zedong-era social safety net was dismantled, Chinese households also became big savers. So right now, with the economy suffering, they're sort of hitting the pause button on big-ticket non-essential purchases.
The domestic economy is not in a good position for the consumers to splurge. And the government can certainly do a lot of things, but they cannot force people to cheer up and spend.
As we saw with record travel and box office numbers through the February Lunar New Year holiday, many of today's young adults, faced with diminishing job prospects and slimming wallets, are choosing leisure over luxury.
During pandemic, people realize how close you can be leaving this world for the paradise. And then at that moment, it probably doesn't matter that much how many material goods you have, how many houses you have, how many cars you have, but rather your experiences.
It's a new phenomenon for sure for newlyweds, previously accustomed to having at very least a new home by the time they marry.
Yeah, we've been planning to get married, and getting married means we have to be prepared for property and raising kids. We need to be more prudent.
We just got married, and I'm very hopeful for the future married life. I hope we can go through the hardship together.
It should be share our happiness, can't be just hardship.
Yes, enjoy our blessings together.
After decades of runaway growth, there is a palpable sense of unease in Beijing. And while piano, home, and other big-ticket item sales are slowing amid less than reassuring policy, there's still the somewhat universal need just to be heard.